Now, there are several theories about what's going on. One is that this sick society that created the psychosis is just crumbling.
It
is. Created the bank failures, that created global depression. That society is crumbling. And what's important about these occupations is the place, because what is happening is that these new societies are being built in these places with infrastructure in the ruins of the old dead one.
We're very much a phoenix society. We are rebuilding ourselves.
A phoenix society rising from the ashes.
We're doing it in a slightly different way. We're not waiting for it to be completely consumed. Enough of it has been consumed. There are more than enough ashes. We are using those ashes to add nutrients into the soil as we plant the seeds.
Do you believe that the Occupy places and the infrastructure of that new culture that's being built, the places, the taking root in these places, is important?
Yes and no. I think that the places strategically where we're, like, camping is part of the strategy. It's showing a society without walls. It's living openly and honestly. That placement is very important. The placement of where we're camping, like, 101 is the Federal Reserve Building, which is not federal. It's not a reserve. It's a private bank.
Right, the Fed and the Federal Reserve.
The evils of the Fed and the Federal Reserve. And
they're
whatever,
two different entities.
They are, and a lot of people don't realize that.
What I'm questioning here is that in these places where these occupies are, where they have taken root, an infrastructure is being built. And if you suddenly move it, you lose that infrastructure.
I think the real infrastructure is in our hearts.
Now we're talking about...
You're talking about physical, like, infrastructure.
Things that you need to function physically. In the infrastructure is what you build, the structures that you build in place. All of that in this mammon culture, that's infrastructure.
Right. And that stuff that
And you're replacing it. Occupy's replacing it.
We're not replacing it. We're just utilizing their infrastructure in new and sometimes different ways. We're reevaluating the worth of something. Down behind, we have somebody working on this big mural that is just merely creating art and the sense of beauty.
What about
and that's
things
using
like
scavenged
the,
materials.
What about things as basic as a place to pitch your tent or the porta potties? That's all infrastructure.
Well, personally, I
mean,
I don't,
it's hard to move those porta potties from place to place. Say,
personally, I don't think that the tents. Certainly keep us a lot warmer and they keep us dry. I mean, it's San Francisco in the winter. Rainy season is, like, right around the corner.
But what if it were Boston?
Then
that's hella cold.
Then I would be all in favor of building igloos on the side of the road or building large community, like, get a bunch of tarps and tents, make one massive community shelter.
So you want it to be able to be mobile.
I think that in order for the occupation movement to be successful and to continue on, it has to be mobile.
Okay.
And as far as the porta potties, well, we were talking earlier on how far we have as a society have drifted from the mother.
Drifted from what?
From Mother Earth and from the planet as a whole.
Yes.
So, like, there's a tree right there if I really needed to. Add a little bit of fertilizer to the soil, no big deal. I think the porta potties they're a luxury. The tents are a luxury.
Okay.
What we need, like, yes, you need shelter from the elements. Well, right now that shelter is coming in the form of tents. It might come in the form of foreclosed homes that we reclaim because it's our money. They received our money from the bailouts and all of these people don't have homes. There are enough abandoned and foreclosed homes in San Francisco. There's like 3 houses for every homeless individual.
That's true.
That is mind-boggling.
That is mind-boggling.
So taking these places over that are technically public places. They may not have been intended as public places, but as soon as the banks received that money from the government, they became public places.
So what you're suggesting is that the Occupy movement can function by being mobile.
Oh, yes.
It does not have to be rooted in one place. So that if it is raided and forced to move, the having creativity and willing to be flexible is very important.
Well, there are definitely... There's things that make our job a little bit easier. Like, we have that massive school and the library that has, like, 2,000 books.
Like, what about the Wall Street Library? They confiscated 4,000 books, and those were nice books. And now the lawyer for Occupy Wall Street is going to court to get those, you know, some recompense
for that
is something that has to be in one place.
I agree wholeheartedly, and that's there are certain iconic places that should be a little bit more permanent, like whether it's a library, whether it's a school, whether it's the medical tent, whether it's...
Right.
There are certain places that need to have a little bit more of a rooted structure. But those places are only facets of the movement. They're a physical representation of the ideas of the movement. And those ideas, once instilled in us, aren't going to go away. In order to perpetuate these ideas, having 600 books that you can be like, this is a library, certainly makes that... The message of free education a lot easier to digest when you have all of these books that you can educate yourself with.
Good. Okay.
But they're not needed. Needed is a discussion of what do you think about blah? What do you think about blah? Oh, I think this. You think this. What about we try this? Oh, crap. Okay, cool. We don't have to reinvent the wheel here. We just have to put the car into drive and move forward. So, there are definitely things that can be a little bit more rooted, but I think us being mobile really helps us keep in mind that this is a movement and not, like, it is a move towards change. And it may sound silly, but a very simple thing to do to continue in the mindset of a movement is move.
Ha ha!